Today we are going to talk about the rheonics DVM, the high pressure, high temperature, density and viscosity sensor. This monitors density, viscosity and temperature of your sample at the same time. Pressure wise, it's rated up to 2000 bar, which is 30,000 PSI. And temperature wise, it's rated up 200 degrees centigrade, which is about 450 degrees Fahrenheit. So in this segment, I'm going to show you how to open it, clean the sensing element, maybe take a look at it if you expect that there might be some deposits or something. In general, it's a good idea to open and clean that from time to time. You can also clean it in line, and for that, you don't need to do anything. You just need to pass your solvent through this sensor body or the sensor module. So this is the module, and I'll show you the sensing element after opening it. Okay, so ideally you should have received a torque wrench. This is set to 20 Newton meter. You can change it. That is the recommended tightening torque for the nut on top of the sensing element. What we recommend is to open, you should use a vise. A simple vise is more than sufficient. And you put some paper on both sides of it so that the surface is protected. And then mount the sensor module here. Then tighten this. Right. Then take your wrench, make sure that it's set to, if you look closely, you'll see that there's a direction. That's a closing direction. So for opening, you have to go counterclockwise. So you put that wrench in there, and then you set the setting in the correct position so you can actually like move it to open or close it. So right now I have it in open position, and then I go sideways, and that opens up the nut. Okay, so now you can see the nut here. Put it back here. Now, take the tool for removing the sensing element. This is the sensing elements you see. So you take this and you basically, you have the ring already in place. This is the ring that we will use to extract that. So take the tool, thread it in nicely, gently, completely through. That's completely threaded. And now start moving the black ring down till it touches the surface. Then move it again gently, and it's starting to extract the sensor from the body of the module, the DVM module. Okay, you'll feel that there is not much pressure. That's when you can take it out. This is the sensing element. This is also sometimes what we refer to as the DV. This is the DVM, the DV module, and this is the DV sensor. What you can do is now you can actually push the ring back, then hold it with your hand, the neck of the sensing element. And I'm rotating this to open this up. Once that is done, you have the sensing element, as you can see here. This is the element that actually does the measurement. So it's very important that you make sure that this is clean, deposit free, whenever you have done any measurements where you expect some deposits to happen. Good, now let me put this back here. And if you can show the chamber here, so we can take a closer look. So you see that chamber, that is the chamber where the fluid is monitored. The fluid inlet is on this side, and there's an outlet here. That we can also show later after I take it off. Now, you can clean the sensing element in a beaker, like you can put a solvent beaker in an ultrasonic bath and just let it ultrasound for maybe like 5-10 minutes. Typically that is more than enough. You may at times want to change the backup ring and the O-ring. The instructions for that are not in this video, but those are already covered in instruction manuals on our support portal. So once you have done these, whatever servicing you need to do, cleaning or changing the backup rings, you want to put it back in. So to put it back in, what we suggest is you take the wheel completely out. you generally need to put the tool, screw the tool back to the back of the sensing element. Maybe grease this a little bit with the fluid that you're going to test with. Let's say in this, our case, it will be endodecane. And then you go back and you see there are two ears on the sensing element and there are two notches on the top of the module. So make sure these are aligned with that when you're pressing it in. So you go like this. And you'll click in. There is no directionality to the sensing element itself. So it doesn't matter which one of the ears goes on which side. It's completely symmetric. Now it's fully inside. Make sure that it sits in nicely. You don't have to worry about making it completely flush because that's what the nut is going to do. Now I'm going to start putting the nut back in. This you can do with your hand initially. And then take the wrench, switch it so it's in locking mode now. So to do that, you hold it and then you click it back and then go in the direction as it's marked here for closing. Okay, so on, and you'll hear the wrench click. Once it does that, that has 20 Newton meter torque. Again, if you can see closely, the setting here is 20 Newton meter. That's what you need to tighten it to. Great.
Okay.
So this completes the process of putting the sensing element back in the DVM.